Good evening to the jury members. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay. Good evening to the jury members and the chairperson and all the participants of today's evening. I am Dr. Aldrin Joshua of 2nd BDS from Savitri Health College, Chennai. Quite interestingly, sometime back, I happened to read a novel where the case under trial of juvenile victim gets resolved using the estimation of his dental age, and he gets punished under law of proving that he is above 18 years of age. So this led me to go to a step further and get interested in doing this research, which is my topic of discussion for today, that is age estimation using Williams method in mandibular right third molar 4-8 in South Indian population. This age estimation, dental age estimation, is used in various disciplines like forensic dentistry, archaeology, orthodontics, and several methods are proposed for processing these stages. When I happened to look up for these dental age estimation, which method is the best, I saw two methods which were very close enough to serve my purpose, that is Dembridge's method and Williams method, which were where the tooth development stage is divided into 8 stages. But I took Williams method as it measures the dental age more accurately than Dembridge's method and is in accordance with chronological age. It has high correlation of dental age for both males and females, irrespective of the race and population. It showed lesser overestimation of age when compared to other methods like Nola's method, Gleason and London Atlas, even Dembridge's method. And it from the previous articles, it shows the correlation between BMI and the difference between dental and chronological age. The purpose of the study is to find the age estimation for mandibular right and the right third molar 4-8. For both males and females by Williams method. For this study, I used a digital orthopentagram from 100 randomly selected subjects, that is 50 males and 50 females, ranging from 10 to 20 years of age from South Indian population. I segregated the age like 10 to 10.9, 11 to 11.9, 12 to 12.9, till 19 to 19.9. So you might wonder why 0.9. It is nothing but the adding the fetal developmental age. It's not the 12 years or 12 months. It is just 9 months. So I took that. And the tooth staging that I used was, as I said before, it's Williams to a tooth developmental staging method. For my convenience, I changed A to H tooth development stage to 1 to 8 for easy accessibility. The mean standard deviation, standard error of mean, for both males and females are found along with the correlation of tooth staging using SPSS version 26. So I have displayed the original Williams method and the modified Williams method that you can see. And from the SPSS results, I found that for males, tooth development stage, it showed mean of 5.8. For female, it was 5.9. And standard deviation, it was 1.9 for male, and female was 1.53. And I overchecked the standard error of mean, how it was. And it was very less. It is like for male, 0.2 something and 0.25 for females. So it's very negligible. So this method seems to be promising for me. And I checked the correlation of tooth developmental stage between male and female, whether there is a significance. There was actually no significance. It was p-value, it was found to be 0.116, which is higher than 0.005. So there's no drastic difference between the male and female tooth development stage. It's almost similar. And next I displayed the graph, that is an association graph. From that, we can understand that from 10 to 12.9 years group, the males have tooth developmental stage far than females. And after that age, particular age group, it has changed to inversely to same. Female have far tooth developmental stage than males. And in 16 to 18.9, males are having a tooth developmental stage, that is the mineralization is very closer to females, but it didn't lead them. So this indicates that females have tooth mineralization very ahead, and it helps in the age estimation also. So indeed, when I compared with previous studies, with the Harriet Spencer et al. 1993, the females of lives in the almost like 75% of the seventh stage, that is open apices stage of the root, lies in the 18 to 18.9 age group. Similarly, in my study, it was 80%. So it is more correlating, it is, seems to be similar. Another study with Casper et al. 2009 said the same open apices females were has a mean age, showed a mean age of 18.44 years. So it also had a higher stage accuracy. Similar to that, 80% of the tooth stage accuracy was there in females in 18 to 18.9 age group. Another study, Solar AC, seemed to be different from my study, where it said 75% of the open up SS stage for males, it was in 18 to 18.9, but in my study, I found it was just 20% in that particular age group, but it changed 60% in the 19 to 19.9 years. And if you see the Juvenile Act, despite the fact that third molar is development is irregular, the tooth itself has high incidence of agenesis. It is seen as an indicator of 18 years of age and majority status. A person who has not reached the age of 18 is deemed as juvenile under the Indian Juvenile Justice Act. So according to the Juvenile Justice Amendment Bill of 2006, juvenile is conflict with the law. That means they if they commit an offense, they are not allowed, they cannot be sentenced with the life imprisonment or any other commitment to prison. So prediction of this particular age, 18 years, they have attended or they are reached, this is very important in this type of cases. The results of the present study showed that if the root had open up basis, that is the seventh stage, it means 80% of the tooth developmental stage accuracy will be there for females in the age group 18 to 18.9 and 60% stage accuracy for males in the age group 19 to 19.9 years. So this signifies females have tooth mineralization faster than males and gives clues to many other medical issues. In future, if the study continues, study sample population, I would like to increase, and it will show a better stage accuracy. So it maybe the results could have changed 95% male. If he had a open apices, we can say that he's in between 19 to 19.9, or female, if we can see 17 to 17.9, like that, we can segregate. And this helps in many crime cases of a juvenile. So in conclusion, this modified Williams method utilized in this present study gives accurate age estimation for both males and females between the age of 10 to 20. And the medical legal ages 12 to 12.9, 14 to 14.9, 18 to 18.8 age group, it helps it. So, and maybe the studies, if it undergoes sub stages like in Molas method, sub stages like that, if we undergo, maybe the result would have been more accurate. But as it's a base study, I have done this much. And thank you to the jury members and chairperson for giving me this opportunity.